Hey, this is Elena with Black Sheep 303 Creative, and my project today is a pirate birthday card using the Lawn Fawn Ahoy Matey stamp set that I made for my niece Hannah, who turned 8 in January. So there's the cute stamp set on the left, and I'll be stamping several of these images using Memento Tuxedo Black ink onto some Nina Solar White cardstock, because I'm going to be using my Spectrum Noir alcohol markers to color these images, and both Memento is great with those, and the Nina Solar White is great too. And I don't want the bottoms of the palm trees because I'm going to make their trunks longer, so I'm just not getting ink on the bottom and just stamping them in. And then I'm extending the trunks out here with my Copic liner, which is also alcohol friendly, to make them taller. So I'm going to be coloring, as I mentioned, with Spectrum Noir. So I'm starting off with CR8 for her bandana, and then I will add, and her skirt, and then I'll add a little bit of shading with DR5, and then I will blend that back with the CR8 again. For Christmas, we gave my niece a pirate costume that she absolutely loved, and so I'm going with the colors of the pirate costume that we gave her. So the little black sash, so I've got IG8 for that, and then I'll add some shading with True Black, and then I will blend that back again with the IG8. And this girl looks a little bit like my niece, so I'm doing my best to color her the way she looks. So for her skin tone, I'm starting off with FS2, and then I'll add some shading with FS3, which is right under her bangs and like under her neck and along her arms, and then blend that back with FS2. And then she has to have a little pink cheek, so I gave her cheeks with PP3, and then I'll blend that again with the FS2. And then she is a brunette, so her brown hair will be TN7 as the base coat, and then I'll add shading with TN8. And the great thing, I love that combo of browns. You don't even really have to blend the TN8 because it just goes that well together. I'm going to skip a lot of the coloring on this because there's a lot of coloring, but I'm just doing the major portions. So I'm doing TN2 here on the inside of the trunk, and then LY1 to finish off that, like the parchment map and the trunk, because LY1 is slightly lighter than the TN2. And then the gold is going to be base coated in LY1, and then I color over it with CT2, and then I will add some shading with GB8. Eventually, and then blend that back with the CT2. So the gold is a lot yellower than the more tan like parchment and the inside of the trunk. And then the trunk, I start out with TN7, and then I was thinking I would add some like highlights by blending it with TN2, which I'll do here in a second, but you'll see that the TN2 is just way too light. So I decide to not do that and just base coat the whole thing in TN7 and then add shading with TN8, kind of like right along the straps and like under the lock and stuff like that. And that again is a great, great combo on browns. And we're going to skip ahead, and now I'm doing the straps on the trunk with IG8, and then I'm going to base coat that strap that's horizontal with IG4. And then I'm going to add a little bit of IG8 to that as well, a little IG4 on the ship sails. And so here's the IG8, and then I will blend that back out with the IG4, and that actually blends really well together and gets a nice medium gray. And I'm skipping over like all the little things and the ship, but the ship will eventually get a black sail because hopefully you all know pirates sailed with black sails. Now my palm leaves I base coated with DG2, and I'm blending with CG1, but that's very, very light. So I decided to add some DG3, and then to blend them together, I'm taking the DG2 and I'm touching it to the DG3 and then coloring with that color. So it gets like a nice in-between shade that's not too dark and not too light, and then I will blend the whole thing out with the CG1. And I do that for both palm trees. And then for the trunk, I'm adding shading with TN7, and then I'm gonna grab the TN2, and I'm gonna take the TN2 to the TN7 and color with that. So I'm getting a nice blend between those two fairly far apart shades to kind of create a nice highlight on the tree trunks. And then for my coconuts, I'm adding shading with TN8, and then I will color them with TN7. And then I'm going to add a little more shading to the palm trunks by taking my TN7 to the TN8 and just adding a little bit of shadow. And then I blend that again with the TN7 and again with the TN2 to the TN7. And of course, got to have a little sparkle. So I added sparkle with my Clear Spectrum Noir sparkle marker to the diamonds and the gold. And I'm stamping happy birthday and the exclamation point in VersaFine Onyx Black ink onto, I think this is also some Nina Solar White. And I'm just kind of randomly cutting this into a banner shape. I wanted this to be very sort of rustic and freehand, so I wasn't too concerned about how it turned out. And then I'm scoring on an angle on the right and folding it back, and then I will fold it forward. And I should really be like using my bone folder. There you go. And then I will do the exact same thing on the opposite side. So I'm going to score it at an angle and then fold it back and then fold it forward. And that's how you get a nice like funky banner shape. And then to cut my fishtail ends, I'm just going to cut up the middle and then cut from one end to the center and one end to the center to get my funky fishtails. And I was purposely not trying to make these even. I really wanted a sort of offset rustic-y look. And then again, cut up the center from the corner to the middle and from the corner to the middle for your fishtail ends. And there you go. Now here are all my components, and there are a lot of them. So I'm building the whole scene on top of an A2 size piece of white cardstock. And I've got some Ocean Mist Gina K Designs cardstock, which is going to be the sky and then also the wave that goes in front of the beach. And really, I think I should have just used a piece that as the base piece. That should have been A2 sized. And then this is a piece of fresh asparagus, also from Gina K, that I cut into that hill shape just kind of randomly. And then this is Blue Lagoon, also from Gina K, that again, I just freehand cut that like sort of rolling wave. And now I'm sticking my ship behind it with some Zig Tui glue. And then this is, again, Gina K Designs craft cardstock for the beach that, again, just freehand cut that hill. So if you're afraid to freehand cut, don't be. Just go for it. Just do what you think is right. You can't really mess it up. And then you can see why I needed longer trunks on my palm trees. So I'm using Zig and tucking them behind the beach. And then you're going to see this piece of Ocean Mist that I cut, that I actually used a die to cut out. This is the stitched hillside border dies from Lawn Fawn that I used for the wave in front. So I'm going to just adhere this down with a little bit of 6mm adhesive tape and then some Zig 2A glue just right on the front. And then I will add some shading under the treasure chest and the little girl with my TN2 marker. I always like to add a little bit of shading because I think it helps ground the people in the scene and they don't look like they're floating randomly on the beach. And I just kind of go randomly under where they're standing or where the object is placed and just kind of draw a shadow. No fancy shading or anything. And then there's 3mm tape on the back of those guys to adhere them down. And then I've got the little piece of gold that I'll add some shading under, a little extra. And then there's a one diamond that I will add some shading to as well. And then eventually there will be a diamond inside the treasure chest that I will shade with a little bit of GB8. Actually, I'm using TN2 on the shading on the beach. And the parrot goes in place. And then I'm going to decide... Oh, and then the little map goes in her hand. And then I'm going to decide that I need a little more stitching detail to go with the wave in front. So I decided to cut the entire thing out with the second largest die in the Elizabeth Craft Design Stitched Rectangles die set. So I just run the whole thing through my die cutter and get a smaller rectangular shape. But it feels a little flat to me. So I decided to add some waves to the ocean with the two little wave stamps using Gina K Design's Blue Raspberry ink. And then I'm going to use my Spectrum Noirs to add a little bit of dimension to the sand. So I've got GB8 that I'm just dotting randomly around the sand, and then TN2, again, randomly dotting it around, no planning or fancy anything happening. And then just a tiny bit of TN7 here and there for just a little bit of dark spot, just here and there. And that added a lot to the sand, I thought. And now my banner is going down in front, and the entire panel is going to be adhered to a piece of Gina K Designs red velvet cardstock in 5.5 by 4.25 using 10 millimeter Elizabeth Craft Designs clear double-sided adhesive tape. And then on the inside, I stamped your treasure, punched a little heart out of that red velvet, and added a third diamond to finish off the inside of the card. And that is the completed project. And there was quite a bit of coloring. And, you know, if you make scene cards, you know that the scenes are usually a little bit elaborate, but super fun. And, you know, for my special little piratey niece, I had to make her a really cool pirate card. So hopefully I've inspired you to make a cool pirate scene card today. Thanks so much for watching. If you liked the video, please give me a thumbs up and leave me a comment because I'd love to hear from you. If you haven't subscribed to my channel yet, I would love that as well. Supplies are linked in the video description and over on my blog. And here are two other projects I've done in the past using Lawn Fawn products. Thanks so much. Have a great day.